Good morning. Welcome to St. Dominic Church. Thank you for joining us for Mass this morning. Our morning Mass will begin in a few more minutes at 8 o'clock. Thank you.
entrance antiphon for St. John of the Cross. May I never boast except in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, through which the world has been crucified in me and I to the world. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
This morning's intention is for Bob Ellis on his birthday today. So as we enter into these Advent mysteries and this and the memorial today of St. John of the Cross, apostle of the love of God and the soul, the love of the soul responding to the love of God, let us call to mind our sins as we say, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who gave the priest St. John of the Cross an outstanding dedication to perfect self-denial and love of the cross, grant, by imitating him closely at all times, we may come to contemplate eternally your glory. Through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us be seated. We're about to hear a reading from the book of Numbers. Numbers, remember the Old Testament, Genesis, Exodus, Numbers, and then Leviticus, Deuteronomy. Numbers is when Moses is still alive, but they are wandering east of the Promised Land in the area around the Dead Sea and Jericho, but on the Jordanian side. That was called in those days the Moab. And so there's a non-Jew, a non-Israelite, whose name is Balaam. And they say, Balaam, the son of Peor. Well, nobody knows who Peor is anymore, so that didn't help us. And but Balaam is known for being told to prophesy against Israel, even though he's not a prophet, but he refuses to do so. And there's a famous story about his donkey. But anyway, let's go hear this story from the book of Numbers. It takes place, Moses is still alive. We still have to wait for Joshua to lead the people of Israel into the Promised Land. So take it away.
A reading from the book of Numbers. When Balaam raised his eyes and saw Israel encamped, tribe by tribe, the Spirit of God came upon him, and he gave voice to his oracle. The utterance of Balaam, son of Beor, the utterance of a man whose eye is true, the utterance of one who hears what God says and knows what the Most High knows, of one who sees what the Almighty sees, enraptured and with eyes unveiled. How goodly are your tents, O Jacob, your encampments, O Israel. They are like gardens beside a stream, like the cedars planted by the Lord. His wells shall yield free-flowing waters. He shall have the sea within reach, His king shall rise higher, and his royalty shall be exalted. Then Balaam gave voice to his oracle, the utterance of Balaam, son of Beor, the utterance of the man whose eye is true, the utterance of one who hears what God says and knows what the Most High knows, of one who sees what the Almighty sees, enraptured and with eyes unveiled. I see him, though not now. I behold him, though not near. A star shall advance from Jacob, and a staff shall rise from Israel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Teach me your ways, O Lord.
Teach me your ways, O Lord.
Your ways, O Lord, make known to me. Teach me your paths. Guide me in your truth and teach me. For you are God, my Savior.
Teach me your ways, O Lord.
Remember that your compassion, O Lord, and your kindness are from of old. In your kindness, remember me because of your goodness, O Lord.
Teach me your ways, O Lord.
Good and upright is the Lord. Thus he shows sinners the way. He guides the humble to justice. He teaches the humble his way.
Teach me your ways, O Lord.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus had come into the temple area, the chief priests and the elders of the people approached him as he was teaching and said, "By what authority are you doing these things? And who gave you this authority?" Jesus said to them in reply, "I shall ask you one question. If you answer it for me, then I shall tell you by what authority I do these things. Where was John's baptism from? Was it of heavenly or of human origin?" They discussed this among themselves and said, "If we say of heavenly origin, he will say to us, 'Then why did you not believe him?' Or if we say of human origin, we fear this crowd, for they regard John as a prophet." So they said to Jesus in reply, "We do not know." He himself said to them, "Neither shall I tell you by what authority I do these things." The Holy Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Well, I'll just mention the gospel and the reading about Balaam in the book of Numbers, which turns out to be a very pretty, very beautiful prophecy. He's not the most famous for that. He's more famous for if God can make a Gentile speak prophetically, so he can also make a donkey talk. And that's part of the way that Jews look at Balaam. But Balaam does make this beautiful prophecy over Israel, though he's not Israelite. There's a question, who gives him the authority? And that's the question that pops up in the gospel, because the scribes and the Pharisees, they answer Jesus, "We don't know." But they're really saying is, "We don't know how to respond to this without getting ourselves in trouble." It's a political, "We don't know." You don't know, or you don't want to tell me? I asked the Dominican that one time, and he just shut up. Anyway, now I want to tell you about John of the Cross, talking about how how in the Carmelite order, like in other aspects of the church, there was really some bad times. The period of the 1500s was a really hard time for the church. And the Carmelites, the regular Carmelites, had become, in the eyes of reformers, badly in need of reform. So Teresa of Avila, who was born in 1524, she died in 1582, she started out in the Carmelites, and then she broke off in the reform, guided by the Spirit. And the rest of the Carmelites did not trust this reform. Nobody likes reformers because they make us change, and we'd rather just change the channel, which is so easy to do nowadays. But for the Holy Spirit was really working through this Teresa of Avila. So this younger man, John, was from Toledo, south of Madrid, from a very noble family, but a family that had lost its money, so they were in straits. John, his mother sent him to a silk weaver, but he didn't have any aptitude for silk weaving. That takes a lot of skill, manual skill, and that wasn't his strength. So she sent him to a seminary, and he studied there in Salamanca. Yes, he studied in Salamanca. And then, I was thinking of Granada, but this is his early studies were in Salamanca. And he was ordained a priest when he was 25 years old. So he was part of the, then later he found the Carmelites and decided to join them he really was tempted to become a Carthusian, a really austere religious order. But he met Teresa of Avila, and she persuaded him to join her movement, which were the Discalced Carmelites, the Carmelites of the Reform. And she had been authorized, speaking of authority, to found two houses for priests. And so he was persuaded by her. Everybody was persuaded by Teresa of Avila. She was just a force to reckon with, and a beautiful, loving person. And you just couldn't help say, okay, I'll do that. And so here come the angels. Here they come. Oh, just one so far. Okay. And John of the Cross was given a certain pastoral things. Okay, there's so little to say about John of the Cross's life, because he was badly treated by his own Carmelites. First, there were the non-reformed Carmelites who still did not accept the Discalced Carmelites, and they had their houses closed, but they put him in a prison. And the prison was back in Toledo, his hometown, but they were very bad conditions. And he was there for several years in this dark, dark place. After he left from there, he was sent down to southern Spain to hear confessions of the nuns. And there's not a lot of life to say about on the outside. What you can be sure of were his main persecutors were his own Carmelites. You know, when you talk about the Inquisition, and people talk about how evil the Inquisition is, they mostly mean the Spanish Inquisition. They had a gift for cruelty, and like the British. Anyway, Ireland, no comment. But anyway, the Spanish Inquisition was very heavy on John of the Cross. But that was the gift of John of the Cross. His writing is this beautiful monument of the soul speaking in dialogue with God. And it's in terms of love poetry. It's famous around the world. People have lost interest in it, except in certain cases. But the Feast of John of the Cross, or the Memorial of John of the Cross, is an occasion to point it out. And that he talked about embracing the cross, because from the cross comes the resurrection. And from horrible things, comes joy. From suffering comes joy. From death comes resurrection. And so John of the Cross saw that through suffering, and particularly the crosses that others impose on you, like the being forced into silence and then forced into prison, and any kind of possibility of being a preacher were taken away from him. But we honor St. John of the Cross today, a beautiful man, short guy, and he suffered very greatly, but he produced a great treasure of luminous, mystical writing and spirituality. So let us stand for our prayers. We pray for the whole church to have clear vision of heart to recognize and receive Christ when he comes. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That civil leaders pave the way for his coming by promoting authentic human and social values. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the hungry, homeless, and victims of injustice, that they may receive the peace of Christ through practical compassion. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For ourselves, we accept without question the authority of Christ and his church. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Bob Ellis today on his birthday, and for good health for him, and for all of his intentions, and for his family, and we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all those who count St. John of the Cross a great master and director their souls and illuminator of their own hearts in times of suffering, especially suffering from those closest to them, most beloved of them, and yet sometimes the cruelest. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray also for the Carmelites, the Discalced Carmelites, the Order, the OCARMs, the regular Carmelites. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the for all those who died, the astonishing numbers of people dying and getting sick of COVID. So we pray for help in this, divine help in this time. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our private prayers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, you loved us so much that you sent your Son to be our Savior. Bless our needs and prepare our hearts that he may be Lord of our lives forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. For the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share your divinity, you who humbled yourself to share our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have received The wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Wash me, O Lord, from my iniquity. Cleanse me from all my sins. Pray, beloved brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept your sacrifice and your grace, for your grace and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Look upon the sacrificial gifts we offer, Almighty God, in commemoration of St. John of the Cross, and grant that we who celebrate the mysteries of the Lord's Passion, we may imitate what we now enact through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for all the oracles of the prophets foretold him. The Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when at last he came. It is by this gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as we say, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke the bread. He gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. Similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, and with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with St. John of the Cross, Teresa of Avila, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you send to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And to all of you and to all of those watching on live stream, let us share with one another the sign of the peace of Christ. Peace. Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, by the will of the Father and the work of the Holy Spirit, through your death you gave life to the world. Free me by this your most holy body and blood from all my sins and from every evil. Keep me always faithful to your commandments. Never let me be parted from you. Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present.
I believe that you are present.
In the most holy sacrament.
In the most holy sacrament.
I love you above all things.
I love you above all things.
And I desire to receive you into my soul.
And I desire to receive you into my soul.
Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you. as if you were already there.
As if you were already there.
And unite myself wholly to you.
And unite myself wholly to you.
Never permit me to be separated from you.
Never permit me to be separated from you.
Amen.
Amen.
Whoever wishes to come after me must deny himself and take up his cross and follow me, says the Lord. Let us pray. O God, who in Saint John have wonderfully made known the mystery of the cross, graciously grant that drawing strength from this sacrifice we may cling faithfully to Christ and labor in the church for the salvation of all, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The peace and the blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, descend upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.